What's up, guys? It's Trevor with Embers. Behind me is probably the most expensive and the highest quality and the nicest gas grill I've ever seen in my entire life. Question is it worth the money? And if you're shopping for a Kalamazoo product, do you need the gas grill or the hybrid model? Which one's better? Today, I'm gonna answer those questions for you. Let's go. Guys, if you're in the Denver, Colorado area, you can come to our showroom. I'm excited to say we are one of the newest Kalamazoo retailers, and you're gonna be able to see their products in our showroom in Denver, Colorado. I have been geeking out over their stuff for a very, very long time. If you guys know anything about my channel, you know we are the experts when it comes to reviewing high-end gas grills, and there is nothing more high-end than a Kalamazoo product, which I'm so happy to finally get my hands on it. Question is it worth the money? Today I'm gonna get it under the hood and show you. And if you're a Kalamazoo customer or you're thinking about becoming a Kalamazoo customer, one of the questions you might have, because I asked this myself, is would I want the gas grill or do I go for the big dog, the hybrid grill? Okay, so before we actually get under the hood, let's get under some of the let's talk about fundamentally some of the manufacturing process of Kalamazoo and kind of what you're paying for. If you watch any of my other videos, you know they're over a 100-year-old company. They started pre-World War I with steel fabrication. Then they got into dairy fabrication, stainless steel dairy products for dairy farms. And that became really important because we need perfect seams, perfect welding, easy to clean, perfectly smooth. So manufacturing process had to be perfect for dairy products. So bacteria doesn't build up, things like that. You can imagine that'd be a disaster if you got some spoiled milk going all the way across the country, right? Can't happen. Anyways, in the 90s, that morphed into outdoor kitchen equipment. And if you just look at, this is all hand welded and hand polished. I mean, the level of craftsmanship involved in the manufacturing process is absolutely out of control, like nothing I've ever seen. For example, their hybrid grill, which is their most complex product, one of their most complex product. From start to finish, that takes over a week in the manufacturing process. That's why there are some long lead times on this. It's made to order, but that's part of what you're paying for is I've been in manufacturing plants where they're pumping out 800-900 units a day, just poof, 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 poof. That's not this. This is very, very highly detailed, the highest quality of craftsmanship you're gonna find. So that's part of what makes this grill expensive. Of course, this Kalamazoo grill, the gas grill, all their other products you can order in 304 or 316 marine grade stainless steel, not the gas grill. The gas grill only comes 316 marine grade. So if you're in Florida, if you're coastal, this is probably the gas grill that you want because it's 316 marine grade and it is warrantied for it. And trust me, it's gonna hold up. Let's start with aesthetics. I love the attractiveness of the hood, all right? It's kind of like harder lines, almost tiered, I don't know what you call it, tiered this way. And I think just from a curb appeal standpoint, it looks fantastic. Now I'm gonna talk about whether you need this one or the hybrid grill, what are some of the differences. But if we look at the control panel, you can see our knobs are backlit. This controls our rotisserie. And then we have our lighting control here. And then our grease management system. First of all, that rolls out quite lovely. And then these pans, holy cow, these are no joke. So all of our grease is gonna go in here. And this is probably the tidiest and best grease trap or grease management system I've seen in a gas grill. So I love the way that sort of folds away. Now you can tell that we're already dealing with a deep firebox. Now, as we get under the hood, I'm gonna talk about why that's important. But it does have motion activated lights. Our lights are right here. They're not turned on right now, but we do have controls over that. Now we do get our laser cut cooking grates. This is sort of, with our hybrid grill, we have the choice of meat, veggie, fish, or like a full skillet top. These are for lack of a better term, hybrid of a hybrid. No, these are like a hybrid style, so more universal cooking grates. And that's just the design that you get. So here's our warming rack. Now this is adjustable. And what's really cool is we do have a hidden rotisserie system. So we do have a drivetrain motor system that's driving that rotisserie. Our spit rod's gonna go right here. And if you've watched any of my other reviews, when we can get a rotisserie system up on a roof, it can double as a broiler and it makes it much more effective and much more useful and much more efficient. So I love the rotisserie system that we have going on here. Now, of course, I always talk about grill height. So look at all this grill space here. So I got over a foot from the roof of the grill to my cooking grates. And to my spit rod, I have about 7 inches. So I love the vertical space that is afforded to us in this grill. Also, this double hood system, look how well protected this is in here. So I already know that we're gonna have excellent wind protection, which is awesome. Now, there are some components or philosophies from the hybrid system that carry over to this grill. So one is we're not using ceramic briquettes. This looks very familiar to our slide out trays in our hybrid grill. And these work really well at diffusing flare ups and kind of working as flavorizer bars, so to speak. And then we have stainless steel U-shape burners. Now, you've seen me work with cast stainless. Now, cast stainless, I think, are a little more durable, but these have just as good of a warranty and are very, very heavy duty and well protected. So I have no problem with these particular burners. And I'm guessing, yep, it's gonna be a hot surface ignition. So hot surface igniter, which I like. Each burner does have equipped with a safety thermocouple. So if the burners were to go out for some reason, which I don't see happening, the valve will automatically close. So you don't have any safety issues there with the valve system or the burner systems. One of the ideas behind having a really even cooking firebox, and one of the best ways to achieve that, one of the best ways to reduce flare-ups, is the deeper firebox we can have, the further we can keep those burners away from our cooking grates, the better a grill is gonna perform, period. So if you think about that, in order to achieve a really deep firebox, two things have to happen. One, we have to have the space for it, and two, it involves a lot more raw material. So bigger the grill is, obviously the more expensive it's gonna be. So the hybrid grill, as you can see from our video, and we'll show you some clips, that fire is the deepest firebox in the industry. So our burners are way, way down here, even lower than these. And that gapping, I think, promotes the best, most even cook in the entire industry. This would probably be the second best. Now, they wanted to create a standalone gas grill that didn't go all the way down to the floor. So the cutouts and dimensions are similar to some of the competitors. So the gas grill is a great option if we're retrofitting or you're pulling out a competitor, like another luxury gas grill. This can be retrofitted into an existing outdoor kitchen more easy. Versus the hybrid grill, with that firebox pretty much going to the floor, you're kind of starting fresh. So I would recommend the gas grill if you're retrofitting or fitting into an existing kitchen space. The gas grill is going to do it easier. But another way that they've cheated this system is it's still one of the best I've seen as far as standalone gas grills. We're 7.5 inches from the burners to our cooking space. So that's still, I mean, some of the gas grills we sell are like 2 inches. What do you think is going to happen when you have a 2 inches of flame right below where your fatty ribeye is sitting? Flare up city. 7 inches away, you see what we're starting to do? And now the way we combine that is we have heavy, high BTU burners that can sit far away from the grilling system. We're still gonna get 750, 800 degrees, no problem, because of the heavy duty burners. It's just the way that they're designed and the way the firebox is designed to promote good airflow and oxygen in the firebox system and keep the burners away from the grilling space. That's the best way to achieve, and I think the most important feature in any grill you're shopping for is how even does it cook and how good are the flare-ups or reducing flare-ups. if we have a 30,000 BTU burner and the most heavy duty, most, you know, bad, you know what burner on the planet, but it's flare up city, what good is it? It's no good. So that's why the design of the firebox becomes so critical. So the fact that they're able to achieve that, now what are we doing? How are we achieving that depth while maintaining similar cutouts to the competitors? Have you noticed that this grill sits up higher? Look at that, we're cheating. They're cheating it here almost 2 inches. So we're gaining 2 inches of it above the counter space. So those 2 inches are critical in creating a better, beefier firebox that's gonna perform better while still maintaining the cutouts for ease of use and ease of installation. So really this 2 inch cheater, I guess you could call it, is my favorite part of this grill. It's underrated, but that's what's really gonna set it apart from the competition, is this deep, deep firebox that is really well designed to promote even heat. So, do you need this grill? What's the advantages of this grill versus the hybrid? Why would you buy the gas grill over the hybrid? One, price. So, when we get rid of some of the hybrid components, it becomes a more affordable grill. So this is more affordable than doing the hybrid grill. It takes up less space. So on our hybrid grill, we pretty much have to build our cutout almost all the way to the floor. All right. So it's gonna take up less space. So if you're retrofitting, the gas grill's probably a no-brainer, especially if you don't wanna modify your outdoor kitchen a bunch. Other reasons to go with the gas grill. Let's just say you already are in love with your smoker. Let's say you have a Primo, a Big Green Egg, Kamado Joe, an offset. Like, let's say whatever you smoke with is what you smoke with, and you just need the highest quality gas grill that exists, and that's all you're gonna use it for is gas grilling, then this is another reason to go with this. Why would you go with the hybrid? Well, the hybrid is the deepest firebox in the industry. So the fact that those burners are even lower in the hybrid is gonna even promote a better cook. So if you want the best performing grill and you can afford it and price is not an issue and cutouts are not an issue, go with the hybrid. And then even if you're just using it as gas, the hybrid's still the best of the two options, if that makes sense. But you gotta have the space for it and you gotta have the dough for it. Now, neither one of these grills are cheap, but the hybrid's even more expensive. So this is the most well-designed gas grill I've ever seen. I've been saying that all day as I'm reviewing these products. And if you wanna come see the gas grill, you can come down to our showroom in Embers in Denver, Colorado. This is going to be on display. We'll see you guys next time.